Welcome, everybody, to Optech's booth lecture. Today we have Dr. Ivo Silva from Portugal, who would be sharing with us his experience with Precizon Go, the newest member of our Precizon family. He's been implanting a few lenses already, and he will talk about his experience and his outcomes. Thank you, Dr. Silva.
Thank you, Ursula. Can you hear me all right? Yeah. So, thank you for coming. First of all, my name is Ivo. I'm from Lisbon, Portugal. I work in two hospitals in Lisbon, in Cascais. And I want to talk to you about my experience this year with Precizon Go. And if the standard, if the monofocal plus class of IOLs is the new standard in cataract surgery. So when we talk about cataract surgery, what is it that we really want? For me, the answer is quite easy. We want happy patients. We talk about good vision. We don't want to have any photopic complaints or anything. We ideally want our patients to be spectacle independent, but the most important thing is that we want to meet our patients' expectations and we want them to be happy at the end. I'm not going to bother you with the importance of near and intermediate vision. Everybody knows this already. The time where we implanted monofocal IOLs in our patients for ametropia, feeling that they would be happy with no regards for intermediate and near vision, is gone. So we all need to have that in mind when we choose the IOL for our patients. And with that in mind, this is a defocus curve. This was from Dr. Nanavati, that basically shows the defocus curve of all the four main IOL types that we use nowadays. The monofocals on the left, the monofocal enhanced or plus, the EDOF and the trifocals. And with the defocus curve in mind, we have to know the basic differences between the different classes of IOLs. We have to know that if we want our patients to be 100% spectacle independent, we have to think about a trifocal lens on top of every other. But we also have to think about the dysphotopsia profile. We know that the trifocals have the worst results in terms of dysphotopsia complaints from our patients in comparison to the others. And also we have to think about tolerance to refractive error. We know that EDOFs and enhanced monofocals have shown a bigger tolerance to refractive error, which means that we can play a little bit with the residual refractive error of our patients. We can leave them a little bit myopes if we want to increase the quality of their intermediate and near vision. And finally, cost. We don't talk a lot about cost when we come to these meetings, but cost is an issue. And I'll go back to that at the end of the presentation, because when we want to manage patients' expectations, if they have to pay more for a particular IOL, that will come into play with their expectations and their happiness after surgery. So basically the Precizon Go, I started implanting it earlier this year. It fits in the family of the Precizon IOL, so they already had the monofocal and the monofocal toric, which have very good results in terms of distance vision, and the presbyopic NVA with the toric model as well, that as a trifocal gives you near, intermediate, and distance. The Go is really an IOL that focuses on distance and intermediate, and if we play a little bit with the residual refractive error, we can also get some near. So basically, the platform is the same as the monofocal, but where in the monofocal the light rays converge in one focal point, which gives the patients very good distance vision, the light rays spread, forming an elongated focal point, which basically gives distance and intermediate vision. The dioptric range is basically the same, and it's very large, which is very good. This is an optical bench study that basically stands to show that the optical quality of the image with the Precizon Go is similar to the Precizon monofocal, which basically tells us that the quality of the optics and the image is very good. And at the same time, we can see the defocus curve showing us the flattening of the curve, which basically shows us that it has a better performance at intermediate without compromising the distance vision. So basically, this demonstrates that Precizon Go provides good optical performance in comparison to the monofocals. This is another study that basically reports patient satisfaction with bilateral implantation of Precizon Go. And the reported outcomes were 100% and 96% of very satisfied patients with their far and intermediate vision respectively, with 85% of patients never reporting any glare or halos. And it's important to point out that these 85% was measured at 1 month post-op, which means that it will probably only get better with time and with neuroadaptation. This is the next slides focus on a study by Dr. Jeong from South Korea, where the Precizon Go was compared with high hands, which we have to say is the standard in enhanced monofocals nowadays. And basically, they have shown that in distance-corrected vision, either in photopic and scotopic, the results are pretty similar. The defocus curve is almost the same. And for near vision, it's actually a little bit better than with high end, especially in photopic conditions. So that's where this IOL fits. This is the group of IOLs where a Precizon Go fits. I'm just going to talk to you about two clinical cases I did surgery on a few weeks or months ago. The first one is a very standard cataract case, a 70-year-old female complaining of blurry vision. She has basically nuclear cataracts in both eyes. She had a recent myopization of refraction. And we basically decided to do bilateral sequential cataract surgery with Precizon Go on both eyes, targeting plano on both eyes, which was what I did when I first started using this IOL. Basically, this lady is 100% for distance, and she's only wearing glasses for reading and not anything else. So she's very satisfied with her distance and intermediate vision. Happy patient. It's like happy wife, happy life, happy patient, happy life as well. That's like my motto. The second clinical case is more of a refractive case. So this is a 59-year-old male that comes to us wanting to get rid of glasses. He's an eye pro with a really bad vision without correction, and he's very keen on not wearing glasses. And so we basically, on this type of patient, evaluate all the different options, not only monofocals plus EDOF and trifocals. But sometimes this choice is complicated and cost comes into consideration. And in my particular market, patients frequently have to pay for a lot more if we choose EDOFs or trifocals. So for a case like this, and if I'm able to explain to the patient what he can expect from the IOL, I've been having good results using enhanced monofocals, even in refractive cases like this. So in this case, I targeted plano on his dominant eye and minus 0.50 on his non-dominant. And he's telling me that he doesn't need spectacles most of the time, only really for small print. So he's able to read a newspaper and to use his phone. And he's basically just using his spectacles for small print. Very happy patient. So this is just a very small video. I will go back to the discussion just to show the implantation of the IOL, just to show how straightforward it is and fluid. It's a plunger injector, so you can basically do a bimanual technique where you can use your left hand or right hand if you're left-handed to help the bag right the lens right into the bag, and it's very well centered. It's pretty easy and straightforward. So going back to the question at the beginning of the presentation, is the monofocal plus my new standard for cataract surgery? I show you the survey from ESCRS from 2020, 21, and 22. And earlier in 2020, there was not even a space on the plot for enhanced monofocals. Whereas now, we've been seeing around 10% of patients being implanted with enhanced monofocals for presbyopia correcting IOLs. These are not standard cases. These are cases where the surgeon wants to correct presbyopia, wants to have presbyopia, is regarding spectacle independence. And one in every 10 patients, more or less, is being implanted with an enhanced monofocal by international on ESCRS surgeons. So this type of IOL is kind of finding its space in this type of patient. So, me myself answering my question, is the monofocal plus the new standard? For cataract cases with little or no refractive expectations, for me, it's a resounding yes. So, if I feel that I have an IOL with no disadvantages over standard monofocals, only slight advantages in intermediate vision, and if that usually for the patient means no extra cost, which is the case in my particular market where enhanced monofocals are covered by the insurance, this is my standard for cataract cases. In refractive lensectomy cases with bigger refractive expectations, the answer is no. But it's complicated. And why is it complicated? Because of patients' expectations. And we always talk about the mantra of under-promising and over-delivering. It's very hard to under-promise if you're asking for a lot more money. If the patient is paying a lot more for an EDOF or a trifocal, then it's their expectations are going to be higher even if you try to under-promise. Whereas with this type of IOL, if the cost is the same, if there are no disadvantages, and if in particular patients like hyperopes, for instance, you can give them a much better distance vision, much better intermediate vision, and reasonable near vision with a bit of myopia, they will be happy with this solution. So basically that's what I wanted to tell you. I don't know if there are any questions, feel free.
Are there any questions for Dr. Ivo? No? Thank you very much, Dr. Ivo, for sharing your experience.